So to change the brake pad, first we need to do is remove this split pin, and then remove the brake pad. To remove the brake pad, we need to have some space, because the brake pad will go downward only, and for that either we need to remove the brake caliper using these screws, or we can remove the wheel and the wheel using this, and then we can put the brake pad, remove the brake pad and put them. So today I will try to remove these screws and then change the brake pad. So let's do it. There are two methods to remove the brake caliper as well. Either open this screw and then remove the brake caliper the way I have removed it. Another method is to open these screws and remove the brake caliper from the hanger, and let the hanger, this is the hanger, let the hanger be on, mounted on the bike frame. Problem with this is whenever you remove it, it changes the alignment of the brake caliper. So at the moment I don't think there is an issue with the alignment of the brake caliper, and neither do I want to touch it. So felt it's better to remove the brake caliper with the hanger and just change the brake pads. So let's do it. So for that, we need to first flat the split pin. Then we just need to pull it up, so you can see flat pin is out, and now you can push the brake pad, and this brake pad is out. So you can see the brake pad is in fairly very bad condition. You can see the dirt in my hand. So yeah, I will replace the brake pad with this brake pad with new brake pad, and before that I need to clean the caliper for the dirt and everything else inside, because you can see it's very quite dirty inside. So we need to chew that, and and then the bike will be ready. So stay tuned. Clean the caliper, and you can see the amount of dirt that came out of the caliper. So it is always necessary to clean the caliper whenever you open it or you change the brake pad. Also, to put the brake pad first, I need to, there is not enough gap here, so I can insert the brake pad. Taking out was fairly easy, so I'm adjusting the gap. So yeah, now you can see I have enough gap. So I already have a brand new brake pads, which I will I'm going to put it in. Yeah, it just slides in, and then what? So then I will just put back the split pin. Yeah, and then I will use the plier to split the pin. And so what will happen is now the brake pad will not fall off. And so now we are going to put this caliper into the wheel, and just to put this we need to align it properly. And so after aligning, just put it here. And put back those screws.
Now you can see the caliper is tight, but there is a grab from the right side, so which I have made to insert the brake pad. So now I'll put it back, and then I'll try to keep a gap of around 1 to 2 mm between the rotor and the pad, which I think it is, and then I will try if the brake pad works.